You are welcome to the Talking Point. This is Journalist for Attitudinal Change. I am your presenter, Prince God's Power Joseph. This channel talks about change. We encourage people not to involve themselves in bad characters like stealing, hand robbery, kidnapping, prostitution, drug, and the other bad characters that can put them to shame. You are welcome. We want you to know that you can make it without involving yourself in crime or in any bad character that can cause you not to succeed in life. People who involve themselves in bad characters automatically regret at the end of everything. So we want you to know that you are somebody and you can make it without involving yourself into bad character. I want you to watch this video before we continue.
Seems very sacrilegious. These suspects, as an established modus operandi of breaking into churches, usually late at night or in the wee hours of the morning, are stealing musical equipment from the church. Investigation so far conducted shows that this gang has broken into over 16 different churches located in different parts of the Federal Capital Territory, especially the areas surrounding the metropolitan part of the FCT. Two of the suspects are here. One is Monday Akao, 39 years old, from Nasarawa State, who is actually a principal participant in this crime. As soon as these items are stolen, and gentlemen of the press, you can see those 12 piano keyboards that were recovered from them. As soon as these items are stolen, they are loaded in vehicles. And Monday Akao, who also impersonates as a military officer, will dress himself in the full-fledged uniform of an army captain and sit in front of the vehicle. And wherever he comes in contact with security men, introduces himself as a senior officer with the Nigerian Army from the military band. And with that, he was able to beat security for weeks on end or for months on end until we eventually caught up with him. If you look at the beret he's wearing, it is also clear that this is not the Nigerian Army beret. But every other thing he had on had the semblance of that of the Nigerian Army. But this guy is not of the revered Nigerian Army. He is fake. He's an imposter. He is a thief camouflaging himself as one of us. They also have got ready buyers, and we have one of such buyers or receivers of stolen property, as the law prefers to describe such persons. And here is Joseph Orazulike, 35 years old, who resides in Efaba State at Maraba. He is a ready buyer of all the musical equipment stolen from the different churches. Incidentally, the investigations we conducted equally shows that Monday has had a long history, or rather a long battle with crime. He will, during his interaction with you, show you scars of pellets injury that he sustained when he attempted to steal from a welder shop. He was shot at by a civil security man who had probably a Dane gun or a pump action. In spite of the grace of God that saw him survive that incident, rather than repent and be of good behavior, he has continued to dig deep into the world of crime and criminality. Today, he has come to the end of the road, as we will do everything possible within the ambit of the law to ensure that he spend the remaining years in jail and serve out his legitimate jail sentences.
What did you do?
I stole for church, sir.
Stole
from church, sir.
How many churches have you stolen from so far?
16 churches, sir.
How many churches?
16, sir. 16 churches.
Can you remember some of the names of the churches you've stolen from?
Mountain of Redeemer.
Say it again.
Mountain of Fire and Redeem.
Stole from Mountain of Fire and Redeem Church. When you steal these things, how do you take them out?
You and my boss teach me, sir.
How did your boss teach you?
He teach me when we bring it out, that will keep me, that I should wait. We'll go and find Moto and bring the Sharon down. Then if we bring all again, anyone that is here, then I will take it to this man, will give me uniform, inside in back, I'll wear the uniform.
What kind of uniform? Choir uniform?
No, that is Nigeria Army, because he told me that it's a Nigeria Army.
So you wear Nigeria Army uniform?
Yes, sir.
Why do you want to desecrate the Nigerian Army uniform? Why do you wear the Nigeria Army uniform?
Sir, that is my brother told me that is a pass I can use to deal with.
Oh, no, you use it as a pass, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, that's fine. How much do you sell each of those?
Yeah, the keyboard, the one that is not neat. When my boss teach me, because before he travel, teach me that he sell 60,000, 70, 90. The last one I sell 90.
Who are your buyers? Give him the microphone. Before you speak, stand up, Monday. Hold these two pictures and show it to them. Who is the man in that uniform?
It's me, sir.
What rank are you wearing there? But you are the one. Look at them.
Yes, sir.
That's good.
My name is Joseph Olazilike. I'm 35 years old. Olazilike, I'm 35 years old.
You are from where?
Anambra.
Do you know Monday?
Yes, I know him as officer.
You know him as what?
Officer.
As officer of
what?
Military.
Soldier man.
How many musical equipment have you bought from him in the past?
I bought 6 keyboards, Mr. Ambassador's speaker.
I can remove that.
How much have you paid so far?
As a bring it as a soldier man, I will sometimes 60,000, it depends how the needs of the people is. Sometimes 70, 90.
Okay, sit down. A message to the churches in Abuja, in Lagos, in Port Harcourt, wherever the church might be located, we want to encourage you, in addition to the spiritual protection that you provide for the house of God, it is also important that you provide physical security in and around your churches. Our interaction with these suspects shows clearly that these suspects consider our churches to be vulnerable. They consider them vulnerable and weak targets because they believe that there are no guards, no security of any sort provided in and around these churches. We encourage church operators, church proprietors, leaders, and heads of these churches, not just to provide human guards, but also to install cameras in their churches. Also ensure that as much as possible, you provide sufficient lighting in and around your church. As soon as it's dark, make sure you turn on these lights. These actions will serve as strong deterrents against the breaking in and stealing of church equipment.
We just want you to know that you are somebody and you are made to be an important person. Don't look at the situation you face today. Don't look at yourself down. Don't take yourself for granted. Your life will never be the same as long as you decide that you are not going to involve yourself in a kind of character that will bring disgrace to you and to your family. We are very happy of presenting this program, The Talking Point. And we are happy you are watching. So if you like what we are doing, subscribe so that you be the first person to get our video anytime it is out. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. See you in the next video.